16 years ago, Web 2.0 was in its infancy, and the website looked like this. They are made by intelligent college dropouts from Harvard. Here comes a funny Danish dude named DHH and created an entire blogging system like Facebook in just 15 minutes at a live conference. A jaw-dropping moment for all developers, which would have taken months, even a year to make. How did he do it? Because David Heinemeier created a framework in 2003 for his startup Basecamp called Rails. A year later, Twitter.com was created. A social media platform with over 100 million users and 340 million tweets. What did they use? Ruby on Rails, an open source web development framework which allows developers to quickly build websites which uses backend and databases. You want faster, better and less painful ways to develop such websites? Use Ruby on Rails. Some of biggest internet websites like GitHub, Shopify, Airbnb, Square, Twitch, Code Academy, Kickstarter all use Ruby on Rails. The average backend developer salary is about $75,000 and average Ruby on Rails developer salary is about $107,000. How? Let's find out in this video. Ruby on Rails is made up of two parts, Ruby and Rails. Ruby is an object-oriented programming language created in 1995 by Yukihiro Matsumoto. Ruby is a general-purpose interpreted programming language just like Python. For example, here is a side-by-side comparison of Python and Ruby. Ruby is even less code, no use of colon. Easy, right? Ruby is the foundation on which Ruby on Rails is built. Ruby language is a pleasure to work. It is easily readable, object-oriented, and it's Python-like syntax. Let's get back to Rails. A framework is a set of code libraries, data structures that provide generic functionality that can be used, overwritten, and further specialized. A library typically provides some functionality which just sits in our code and acts only when we call it. Ruby on Rails is built upon a basic software design principle, DRY. Don't repeat yourself. DRY code is easier to maintain. It also follows a principle of convention over configuration. Rails is very opinionated, and most of the times they are not controversial. You can also override the default configuration. The Rails framework can pay big dividends as your web application matures and grows. To get started, we need to first install Ruby and then Rails. Go Rails has a complete guide on their website. Generally, I use Rails installer. The website railsinstaller.org is down since July of 2021. So we need to use Wayback Machine. Go get your installer file depending on your operating system. I'm using Windows. This is Rails 5 installer and Ruby on Rails version 6 was released in August of 2019. So head on to Ruby installer and download the dev kit version and install it. Then open the terminal and type gem install Rails. Restart the terminal or shell and type rails-v. If this runs, that means Rails is installed correctly. Yeah, but do not forget to install Node and Yarn or else you will get weird error messages. Create a new Rails project with Rails new command. Then open the project in your favorite text editor. Enter command Rails S or Rails server. Both work the same. Go to localhost 3000. There you have your Rails project. Now let's look into our Rails project. There are three folders we need to focus on: model, view, and controller. The Ruby on Rails framework uses MVC architecture. M stands for model, V stands for view, and C stands for controller. Model refers to the data that we put in our database and is usually a Ruby object. The view is a presentation layer and it is what the user sees and interacts with, which contains HTML, CSS and JavaScript. The controller responds to user interactions through browser requests. In a basic web architecture, a browser requests a page from a server. If database is enabled, it interacts with the database and pulls information, and the entire control is in this single page. In MVC, the browser communicates with controller, which contains the code involved in making decisions. If it requires database, our controller talks with the model, which contains the code involved in connecting with database, and returns its results back to the controller. When the controller is ready with the result, it will send it to the view, the presentation layer. The view contains HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, and which then return back to the browser. Once again, controller handles decision, model handles data, view handles presentation. Keep that in mind. This has been Ruby on Rails in 100 seconds. You want to learn more about Ruby on Rails? Traversy Media has an excellent Ruby on Rails tutorial, which is made by WebCrunch, whose entire channel is based on Ruby on Rails. And welcome to Watch to the End Club. You are absolutely amazing.